In one brain freeze moment, Texas Senator Ted Cruz may have blown up all his chances to win the Republican primary and the general. After all the work he did to shore up his MAGA credentials, offering to argue the Supreme Court case for Trump, the race with Josh Hawley to find out who runs the farthest into the right by contesting the Electoral College count on January 6th, Ted Cruz had swallowed his pride so many times in the last 5 years as he evolved from hate Trump to love Trump.
Talk to the president the way you talk to my brother, Ted. You afraid of him? You think he'll smack you down at home?
Oh,
is that
yeah.
what it is?
I'm
like he shut you up in the primary?
Cuomos. You guys
not
are really
Cuomos.
Tough.
I'm talking about the president. My brother's not the president. I'm talking about the president, the one who called you a liar, the one who said your wife was ugly. That guy, you know, the guy now who you won't say anything about.
Ted Cruz sidestepped on all the abominable things that Trump said about him and his family. Lying Ted, ugly wife, the things about Cruz's father. Ted let go of all of that, and he did with only one thing in his mind, and all those years and years of effort to build his profile up, like shutting down the government in 2013, and the strenuous effort to be seen as the outsider inside the Republican camp. So much effort to stand out. He burned as many bridges as he could on his way, but all that years and years worth of effort has come to a naught in one single day. I don't know if you feel it or not. It does feel like 2020 and even 2021 is a period of divine payback for so many politicians. We all could have been easily lulled into complacency by the smooth-talking Josh Hawley, who owns an enviable resume, but his ambition to shut down the path to his right from potential Republican primary opponents saw him flip a finger to moderates and independents in one go. Now the entire country knows where the Ivy League educated, highly polished looking and skilled speaker Josh Hawley stands. No matter what he does, he may not have the access to the center of the country. He lost the key to the town full of moderates and the key is lost forever. Now the second presidential hopeful, another Ivy League educated senator who strenuously built his profile for the last 10 years before taking the hard right turn early this year, made a monumental blunder by traveling to Mexico, even as snow laid down a suffocating chokehold on the state of Texas. Cruz tried to walk out of the error by pointing his fingers at his family, and his first excuse was, "I wanted to be a good dad, so I went to leave my family in Mexico and got back immediately." Not a bad idea, it could have blunted some of the criticism. And if he is back in Texas immediately, then the national media's attention could be diverted away from his trip. But sadly, Cruz made another mistake here. The kind of things that we all do when we make a trip that we never really planned for. Text messages sent from Mrs. Cruz to friends and Houston neighbors on Wednesday revealed a hastily planned trip. Their house was freezing, and as Mrs. Cruz put it, and she proposed a getaway until Sunday. The national media dug out all the information we needed, and Mrs. Cruz left plenty of them on group chats, which made its way to national media. And text messages revealed that the plan was to stay through the weekend. And as a result, Cruz had no choice but to accept that was the plan. The plan had been to stay through the weekend with the family, Cruz reportedly said, framing the decision as a parent's attempt to placate his two daughters, aged 10 and 12, after a tough week. Now, there really is no getting back from this fiasco, because it will stay, and it will stick, and it will hurt. May not be enough to torpedo his chances when he runs for the Senate in Texas, but extremely potent to blast his chances to win the general in 2024 if he becomes the Republican nominee. To be honest, if Mr. Cruz was some rich guy living in Texas, no one would have the right to point fingers at him for escaping the Texas weather. But he is not just another person. He is the elected representative of the state, and he made it clear for all of us that he seeks a national profile. He was the number two in the Republican primary in 2015. Had Marco Rubio and John Kasich dropped out early, Cruz may have won the primary against Trump. So if you seek the presidency, you have to let go of certain luxuries. That's the cost of seeking that position. Ted Cruz knows this, and that is why, in a way, this is baffling to see him make a blunder of this magnitude at the worst possible time. He was not punished for his actions leading up to the January 6th and on January 6th. But as bad luck would have it, he is going to be punished even more for his decision to take a break, a vacation. Welcome to politics, Ted Cruz.